time to call your lawyer.
Indeed we do. Call our friend and attorney for the injured, Bruce L. Shiner, and get the question of the week answered. Maybe your question gets answered this week. If you have a question, I'll tell you how to submit it for next week's Ask the Lawyer if you'd like to. First, before we go any further, let me just say that what you're about to hear should not be considered specific advice in your specific circumstances. For that, you've got to sit down face-to-face with a legal professional. You can't do that by listening to the radio or anything along those lines. But the good news is Bruce L. Shiner and Associates, like some lawyers, offer a free initial consultation. I'll tell you how to contact their office in a second if that's something that appeals to you. In the meantime, some great legal advice that we can pass along that applies kind of across the board in all circumstances. Don't sign anything. Don't make any statements. And don't let anybody record any conversations until you've sought the help of a legal professional. With that in mind, let's see what Bruce thinks of this week's question of the week at Kix Country 92.9. Would you please help me welcome Bruce L. Shiner, attorney for the injured. Good morning, Bruce.
Good morning, Todd. How are you doing today?
I'm just fine. How are you?
I'm doing great, thank you.
Any more news on the baby front? We found out a couple of weeks ago that going to be a new baby granddaughter.
Yeah, we're excited. We're looking for mid to late January.
Okay. Oh, a winter baby. That'll be nice.
Yeah, real nice in Florida.
If I know you, you've already started making up things in your mind to spoil this little one with. Maybe even bought a teddy bear or two.
I already bought a little pretty pink dress.
Oh, good. Okay. Well, that's terrific. And again, our congratulations to the family. Let's go ahead and get into today's question so I don't take too much of your valuable time and see what you think about it, okay?
Okay, Todd.
All right, it says, my son had stopped at a convenience store to get gas and pick up some soda. While he was in the store, a man came in, picked up a case of beer, and tried to walk out without paying. The clerk came around the counter and tried to stop him just as my son was paying. The man pulled a knife and lunged at the clerk and ended up stabbing my son in the stomach. My son ended up having very severe internal bleeding and had to have emergency surgery and has been unable to work for over a month. The store is claiming that they're not responsible for the other man's actions. It turns out this was the third attempted theft that week. Can the lawyer help me? And the lawyer, I guess, would be you. So could you help in something like that? Can you give us some ideas?
It all goes on the fact that whether or not this store had notice of criminal activity, and it appears that it did, and if it did, then it would be responsible for providing a higher level of security.
Okay.
Here it says it turns out that this was the third attempt of theft.
Right.
The attempted theft was stealing a jar of peanut butter. It really wouldn't come into play, but I think they mean that it was the third, you know, robbery or something of a more serious nature.
Potentially a violent nature, yeah.
Right, and again, it's all a question of notice. If the store is on notice that there's criminal activity, they're taking their patrons' money and they have a duty to provide a safe place to shop.
If this indeed was the third attempt within a week and they were fairly serious attempts, what could a store owner do about that? Perhaps, and I'm just thinking out of the box here, maybe hire a security guard until the police could catch the person?
Exactly. They have to hire a security guard.
Okay.
Because that would be a big deterrent to someone coming in and trying to do that.
Well, and it would have shown them taking responsible action on their behalf. Even if something did happen, it would probably help them considerably.
Yes, I agree.
Okay. Well, it sounds like a lawyer is definitely going to be needed here because there's going to be nothing but finger pointing. It was the guy that robbed the place. It was the clerk that should have just handed over the money or whatever. Point being, they're going to need a lawyer, and that's always the best advice that we like to pass along. Thank you, Bruce.
Thank you.
And we look forward to talking to you next week.
I can't wait.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up again for Bruce L. Shiner, attorney for the injured, and our question of the week. That's pretty scary stuff when it comes right down to it. Now, maybe you're involved in a scary situation. Of course, anything legal can be scary. So why not take advantage of a couple of options? You can send your question in for consideration for next week's Ask the Lawyer segment. Or if waiting to see if your question is chosen next week is a bit more than you're up to, you'd like to get some more immediate answers, in other words, then why not get a hold of Bruce L. Scheiner and Associates in Port Charlotte? If you want to send in a question, go to our website at kixcountry929.com. KIXCountry929.com. Look for BLS Bruce L. Scheiner on the homepage. If you'd like some more immediate help, remember free consultation at 941-743-7777. 941-743-7777 for Bruce L. Scheiner and Associates in their Port Charlotte office. And be sure to tell them that Todd sent you from Kix Country 92.9.